things that you normally don't say he said.
Like what?
Just his comment was, we ain't gonna be hurting for nothing.
Who is we?
He said, we ain't, this is what he told me. I said, dang man, that's pretty sad. I said, financially, that's gonna fuck some shit up. And he goes, we ain't gonna be hurting for nothing.
But Reggie saying that don't mean, you know, that's Shira's involvement or this and that. Because I'm going to tell you something else, man. You know, we don't know, well, we know that Reggie and Shira got close. They grew up together. They're like brothers, right? We don't know how much Shira completely trusts Reggie or will say certain things to Reggie. You know, maybe there's nothing he won't say to him. Then again, maybe there is. Maybe Reggie knows a lot, okay? But I don't think if she'll get anything to do with Tupac's death, he would tell Reggie.
He would.
You think he would?
He would. I know he would.
Like,
Because they're tighter than you think. Everything that Suge does, Reggie knows. Because I tell you right now, anything goes down with Suge, you know who's going to run this company? Reggie.
Wrong. What do you mean? Death row?
He would much rather see it turn over to Reggie.
Nope. Wrong, because then everything comes back on Reggie, right? Everything is pointed at Reggie. That's pressure Reggie can't handle. Let me tell you, if something goes wrong with Shug, who's going to run the company? Common sense, right?
Sharita is on the thing. Sharita's on the paper.
Yeah,
Reggie would carry most of the burden.
Man, I can't see it. I cannot see that. I can't see that.
And you know who I got there from? A good source. A family member. A family member.
Maria?
Reggie's dad.
Reggie's dad.
Reggie's dad told me that.
Wow.
He said, Michael, if anything happens to Suge, this is what he told me. Anything happens to Suge, Reggie would run the majority of the company. And I said, even over Sharita? He goes, trust me. Reggie, you know why? One thing Suge does is trust Reggie. He does. I'm saying Reggie fucked that whole shooting deal up. All that shit was Reggie's fault. Reggie was the one that wasn't with Suge. Reggie was the one who, you know, I was at the hospital when Suge called Reggie in there. You see what I'm saying? I was there. One thing Suge didn't do is he didn't blame any of it for Reggie. And trust me, the shit was all Reggie's fault.
Yeah, it was all Reggie's fault. It should have been blamed on Reggie.
You know, I mean, it wasn't even something where you could debate it. Any common sense tells you that the fault wasn't yours. You had been off for 6 weeks. Every one of them decisions that got me out of there, you in there, and everything else, all that came from Reggie's mouth.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All that came straight from Reggie. That's why this shit was so comical. Because I kept saying, boy, and then when I talked to Mr. When we went jet skiing with Mr. Knight, he told me on the lake. He goes, yeah, if anything happens, anything comes up, Reggie would be the one running the whole day in and day out operation. Suge would turn it to him. Because I'm going to tell you who he wouldn't turn it to. He has more faith in Reggie than he does Norris and, what's it called?
Jeff Lowe people.
He would turn it over to Reggie and say, everything that Suge would get, he would call Reggie, and then Reggie would put it into play.
Well, Mike, you really think setup. I got to ask that question. Do you, in your heart, think it was a setup? That's a hard question.
It's a hard question for me, Frank.
Okay, but see, Mike, it's not for me. You see what I'm saying?
Let me tell you why it was hard. Because I've heard some other, because remember, I hang out with Reggie.
Right.
And you know, me and Reggie, we're sort of tight.
Right.
But you know, me and you and Reggie, I hang out with both of y'all, so I'm telling you from the end that I see with him, when he told me the other day, because like he told me, he goes, yo, man, go order me some red carpet. I go, what? You can put red carpet in your penthouse suite? Are you a fool? He said, yeah, man, I'd have crossed over to the other side. Then he started laughing. Then I said, I know you ain't serious. He goes, man, he goes, I tried this shit the right way. And then we start laughing, right? He just says little things to make me think and to make his dad nervous. You see what I'm saying?
Because
his dad always tells me and Tim, hey, talk to Reggie. Hey, talk to Reggie.
down, Frank. And between me and you, Reggie's in too deep.
Oh, yeah,
he's in way too deep.
Well, we figured that was happening anyway. We talked about that before.
But there's no reason for him to be in as deep as he is. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So he's doing this shit out of loyalty. He's sticking around out of loyalty. Then they said some things, right, that I look back and remember what he said. What you gonna do, Frank? What you gonna do? You know what he wanted you to do? Do you really want to know?
Yeah.
So you know.
Mm-hmm.
See, but his deal with them, that was for real. There wasn't no joke there.
Well, sure, guys, what I was going to do.
Yeah, well, so what you going to do, Frank? What you going to do? Yeah. Do you know what he meant?
No.
You don't?
No, I don't. Obviously, I don't. What did he mean?
He wanted you to take someone out. Okay, Frank, see, I was just telling you. I had to go back and ask Reggie what it meant.
Did you ask him?
I sure did.
Really?
I sure did.
And he said what?
He said that you should be disappearing. What do you think? See?
Like who?
That's what I'm saying. But see, evidently, they know who it was. You see what I'm saying?
That's what I was saying.
Frank.
Yeah.
Maybe say that over and over and over.
Yeah.
What you gonna do, Frank? What you gonna do? My homeboy is gone. I had to go back and ask Reggie.
Well, see, you remember that too.
Yeah, I remembered a complete conversation. There's a reason why I remembered it. Because the first thought that came to mind, they wanted you to take some action. You didn't feel that?
Mike, I probably didn't even think about it. You know what I'm saying?
So I went back and asked Reggie straight into his face. I said, Reggie, what was Sugar implying? And then Reggie, he got sort of stupid on me. Nigga, you don't know what, see what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
He said, you don't know what's up? Niggas need to be disappearing around here. You know, that's how we keep the shit in the fair. You know, that kind of shit. I'm not supposed to be really serious. See, I thought, I said, did these fools convince Reggie?
So, Mike, you think, from who told you it was a $51 million insurance policy?
Resources from Compton.
From Compton.
From Compton.
Well, listen, I heard it from Compton too, okay, and I just heard it yesterday. Okay, and I heard it was the
51 million, and then I know who insured it.
Who?
Lloyd's of London. Lloyd's of London insured it. At definitely the asking price, what they insured it for. Then I know exactly who the beneficiary was.
Sure.
Yep.
So why point everything back to me?
Oh, it has to be pointing towards you. It has to point to you because you take the heat for everyone else. It's logical. It's logical. If we could say, well, security, you know, and then that's why Reggie ain't big to speaking up. Because he knows that they can blame you, and then it's just on you. You know, Frank didn't have his gun. You see what I'm saying? See, and you know what? I got to thinking about the whole thing. Remember when I made a big deal about me being on him and the thing?
Mm-hmm.
Remember when I said, hey, man, I said, I don't know if that shit is right.
Mm-hmm.
I said, because, you know, I've been with him, and they sort of, remember how they shined me off?
Mm-hmm.
Nah, we gonna go ahead. And I said, hey, Rich, I said, I've been with him the whole week. Then he just went. And then he did something that was weird at the table. I don't know if you've seen it. He said, don't worry about it, Michael. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. You see how he got sort of frustrated?
Mm-hmm.
Why? You know what? Now let's think about that. Would he have normally made a big deal with me staying with him?
No, absolutely not. No.
You see what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
That shit was weird.
Yeah, because you were an alternate.
That's right.
You were an alternate bodyguard because Kevin Hackey wasn't there.
That's right.
And Kevin's supposed to have been there.
I had had him, Frank, for the whole week in New York.
Right.
There was no deal for me saying, why would they keep insisting that I do the cash register? They were insisting that. You didn't notice it?
No, I do. I do.
And I'm sitting here going to myself.
Yeah, I was sitting right there in the meeting.
That's right. And I'm saying to myself, why is it a big deal? I've been with this fool. Everyone in the room knew that we had just got back.
Well, see, you can make this spooky because then, in that meeting where everybody was told don't carry a gun anywhere.
Now, wait.
And that's the first time we'd have been in Vegas where somebody said we shouldn't carry guns.
That's right. And then they were really persistent
about you not having one. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
They're going to be checking you. And then they was even trying to convince the people with CCW not to carry.
Right.
Like they wasn't going to give them courtesy up.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Right.
And then I looked at it. Now, we'd have been to Vegas about 5 times, Frank.
Right, right.
Have you ever, ever heard him say, don't carry your weapon?
Absolutely not.
Let me tell you this. What does Reggie always say?
Oh, yeah.
He always says, make sure you have your shit.
Yeah.
Now, after that shit was over, we had all been carrying anyway. So why didn't he say, yo, after he left, why didn't he say, yo, y'all niggas keep y'all shit on you? You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. It's too much stuff going on now.
Frank, I'm telling you, I'm going by the vibe that I seen prior to it starting.
Right.
It even started like someone new.
Well, let me tell you this, what I was told. I was told that things weren't that good between Suge and Tupac within the last few weeks while he was on gang-related.
No, wait, I'm going to go back before. What did I tell you?
It happened on Gridlock, too, though.
What did I tell you what happened in New York that I witnessed?
What?
When he said he was bailing.
Who?
Remember I told you me and Al was riding in the limo and we heard Snoop do an interview with a lady and DJ.
Mm-hmm.
And he turned and he started smashing shit up in the limo. Saying, get me back to that motherfucker hotel. This is bullshit. I ain't got no motherfucker. I ain't got my back. Fuck this. Fuck that.
Oh, your pop.
Remember I told you? When we walked him all the way upstairs with Shoot. To Shoot.
Yeah.
Then we walked him down and he was there. We heard the shit. He was like, man, I'm getting the fuck out of here. You motherfuckers can have this shit. Motherfuckers take back at a motherfucker. Out.
Well, you know what he told me? Remember that when we were walking down the street and I put my arm around him?
He was depressed.
You remember when I put my arm around him?
Yeah.
And I was talking to him?
Mm-hmm.
And then we went to the MGM by ourselves to go to the fight.
Right.
And we were sitting around waiting.
Mm-hmm.
He goes, Frank, I didn't want to come here, no way.
Yeah. He was, you know what?
Yeah.
He was depressed, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Go back to his train of thought.
Yeah, he said to me he didn't want to be there, no way. Well, get this. I was told that while he was on gang related, that last week, he was upset about going to Las Vegas.
Frank, I'm going to go better than that. When you went upstairs to change your clothes, and we were downstairs, I said, man, what's up? Because he was moping, like
what?
A little bitch.
What?
I said, yo, what's up? Man, it's all kind of bullshit. And he told me, he goes, Mike, whatever you do, come back downstairs when you get dressed. I want you to be there. That's And I thought, boy, Pac, if anything, he wanted to ditch me.
Right. But he didn't really try.
Yeah. He ain't never, ever said to me since I've been working for him, come back down, I need you here.
Mm-hmm.
He ain't never said that, Frank. Never. Then when he said that, I got a little concerned. I said, yo, Pac, is everything all right? Because he would sit down underneath one of them little slot machines. And he had his head down. So I said, yo, nigga, what's up? What's up? And he said, man, all kinds of shit. You know, then he said, hey, you coming back, right? That's when you was, he goes, there goes Frank. See, he seen you first.
Right.
He goes, there's Frank right there.
Because I saw him waving to.
That's right. And he said, you coming back, right? That's the last thing he said to me. I said, yeah, you know I'm coming back, man.
The last thing he said to you.
Yeah.
Sure was.
That's right.
Sure was.
See, now I'm looking at that, and then I'm looking at all the shit prior. Now, I'm going to tell you another person who I did a little research on. You know that attorney?
The one that was out there?
Huh?
Yeah.
We were told he was an attorney, right?
Well,
he had a card saying he was an attorney.
Well, I have his card.
Somebody said he wasn't.
Oh.
Somebody said, now Frank, I'm going to be honest, and hear me out, and this is going to make you open your eyes. Frank. Was it necessary for all of us to go there and hear that? Or did just Reggie have to go?
Reggie should have been the only one that went.
Why did we have to go?
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Right. Reggie could have dealt with that and then had a meeting with all of us.
Why was he so insistent that we were there? Remember how much he made a big deal?
Right.
I need all you guys over here. I need all you guys at this guy's. Why did they do that? You have to give me me an answer on that.
Well,
you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Why? First of all, I'm the owner of the company. We're getting the licenses and working. Isn't that business end of it? Isn't that something that's between the manager of the company and the person getting the licenses?
That's right.
Would you never hold a meeting?
Why not? Not with all the employees.
Not with all the employees there?
Yeah.
And then insist that we get there. Remember how he went off? Richie went off when he not motherfuckers wasn't making it?
Right.
You see how mad he was getting at God? And then, look at the message. Really? Did he say anything in that whole meeting, or did he just talk about not carrying a weapon?
That's all he talked about, basically.
What else did he say, Frank?
Yeah.
It was hard for me to even remember anything else he said.
Yeah. I don't remember a whole lot he said either. He made it a point to make sure about the weapons.
He made it a point.
Yeah.
He made it a point that none of us had any weapons.
Right.
Then they even asked me personally, because they know I usually carry mine even like I'm hard-headed. They asked me individually. Because he asked me, he goes, Mike, you're not carrying a weapon, are you?
This was when you got to the club?
No. This was...
At the meeting?
At the meeting.
Because
he goes, because told him that I was with Pac the whole time.
Uh-huh.
And he goes, you're not carrying a weapon up here, are you, Mike? And I go, yeah. He goes, Mike, you can't have you carrying a weapon. See?
Uh-huh.
Why was he so... Why did he go to that meeting? Who was that guy? You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Now, I looked on the door, and you know how the doors it has listed the people that work in that building?
Yeah, his name wasn't on it.
His name ain't on there.
Yeah, I looked too.
His name ain't on there, and yeah. I always do that.
Yeah, I looked too. Especially after he handed me a card.
That's right. Yeah. I made it a point, Frank.
Because he didn't even know where his cards were.
No.
And that's supposed to have been his office.
That was his office, and he was lost.
Yeah.
He didn't even know where the pins were at.
Right. Right. I caught all that.
You know, and I'm sitting here, and I'm going, okay, we got some problems. But I didn't say nothing. But then, when Reggie made a big deal about me and you doing the switch, I knew something was wrong. I knew something was wrong. And I remember I told you. I said, that sure was weird. Ask Tim Williams. I told Tim something was going to happen. They all laughed at me. I said, Tim, something's going to happen.
This was after we left the meeting?
No, it was after I left you and Pac.
Oh, okay.
Because I went back to my room, remember? Remember when I told you that me and Tim stopped in front of the M-Chip Grand? Why would I have done that, Frank? Why would I have stopped Tim's truck? I stopped and I said, Tim, I should get out. And Tim goes, man, you know they ain't going to trip on me. I said, Tim, I should get out. Me and Tim were arguing in front of the M-Chip Grand while the fight was going on. The reason we were arguing is because I kept saying I should get out. You see what I'm saying? And then he was saying, well, you get out. All you're going to do is get Al pissed off if I show up late without you. You know what Al said? He said, get to the hotel wherever he... Get this. We weren't late yet, Frank. We were supposed to be there at 8 o'clock. At 7:30, they were calling my room looking for me. They were looking for me.
Wow.
You see what I'm saying?
It was an hour before the fight.
An hour? They're like, where's Michael Moore? Where's Michael Moore? Where's Michael Moore? But there's a reason, and you know the reason they were looking for me, Frank? Guess who would have had a gun?
You.
Me. And they knew it. So, you know, I'm not going to answer that question if it's a setup, but you know, I'm looking at the whole picture. The whole picture is definitely on the weird side. It's weird. It is weird. Tupac was depressed. He didn't want to be there. He told me in Vegas that he didn't want to, in New York that he didn't want to come.
Yeah, well, he told Kevin that, and he told me that while we were there, too, when we were sitting around waiting.
Yeah. Okay, go ahead. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you know, you're asking me, I'm telling you, some things happened that never happened before. That thing was so persistent, and it was only a meeting about carrying your weapon. I can't even remember, Frank, if he said anything else, but... We're working on you guys getting cards. Don't carry a weapon. We're working on you guys getting your cards. Whatever you do, they're going to be cracking down. They're going to be checking everything. They're going to be coming in there doing this. Everything was negative to scare you. Then we get a card from this guy, who's this is supposed to be his office we're in. Now, here's another thing. Did you notice the pictures? They weren't him, Frank. They weren't him. And you know what I'm thinking? I don't think that guy was a lawyer. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. something about it. Remember? He said, sometimes we work in each other's office or something to that. Remember?
Mm-hmm.
Why would he say that?
It's a lot of unanswered questions.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm telling you, Frank, something is not right. I'm telling you. It just didn't add up. It didn't add up. Reggie was so weird. I'm going to tell you another thing. Let's look at Reggie's thing. Why would Reggie, he never went to that club and started to... Why was Reggie and Larry there? Why was Reggie and Rip and Al there?
Well,
he turns it over to Al every time. He turned it over to you.
Well,
he turned it over to Marcus the time before that.
He was never there.
And he was never there. Why was he so insistent on being there? And I asked him. When I first got to the club, I said, Reggie, why are you here? Aren't you going to shoot? No, I got to take care of some things at the club. And guess what? What did he do different?
Nothing.
Nothing at all. He did nothing. He just was there. He was just there. So I'm telling you, some shit didn't add up. It didn't add up for me. I'm not convinced. By any means am I convinced. You know, the shit looks a little crazy. You know, when you look at the whole picture, why they were so insistent, why are we in an office? This guy's name's not even on the door. This guy's giving us a card saying he's this, but we're in an office where we shouldn't even been. We've never did that. We showed up to this guy, and we had no idea what we were doing there. And he didn't even make sense when we got there. Reggie can normally tell us that. Reggie normally tells us, hey, you know, they're going to be sweating you. You know, don't come in when you first come in. But then when everything heat goes down, I'll get your shit. Reggie told us that. We had a point to have someone else be there to do it. You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You don't think something's a little strange about that? See, to me, the questions aren't answered. They're not answered. Reggie never goes to that club. Never. Did all they kept doing?
Well, what I didn't understand is how come Reggie is Suge's bodyguard and he wasn't with Suge?
Mm-hmm. No, here's something even funnier. Wouldn't Suge have called him?
Yeah.
He knew how to get a hold of Reggie.
He didn't even ask me where was Reg.
That's right. That's right. Why didn't he ask for Reggie? First of all, before he even went to that fight, he would have said, you know where Reg is.
Well. Yeah.
Now, let me tell you this. Have you ever seen Reggie without him?
Nope. Here without him now.
That's right. You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? All the time we go somewhere, who's on that shoe?
Reggie.
Have you ever seen him where he wasn't with him?
Hey, I feel you.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You ask me questions like, and then I'm listening to one end of what he's saying, and one end of what you're saying, and I ain't buying off on that. That's why I won't answer that question about his Eric. Really none of my business, but I'm going to tell you, there was some shit happening